Hi children, warm wishes of the day. Let me call your attention back to the chapter infinitives which we had started yesterday. I just gave you an introduction yesterday about what is a finite verb, what is a non-finite verb, and what are the different kinds of non-finite verbs. One of them was infinitives which we are supposed to learn today. So let's get into our portion. Infinitives, as I told you yesterday, is made with the 2 and V1 or root form of a verb. Yesterday I told you to come, to sit, to laugh, to eat, to go, to come. Whatever you want, you can say. This is what is the form of infinitive. It has got many usages. Some of them we will go through. First one is, infinitives are used as subjects. For example, to lie is wrong. To tell a lie, that's what is, to lie is wrong. Here, to lie, as you know, this is the 2 what I told you, lie is a verb. And to lie, this has become the subject, is wrong, verb and object. Next one is, as object in a sentence, I like to work. I subject, like is a verb, and as an object to this verb, to work. What do I like? To work, to rest, to study, to travel, sorry. All that we use, and so infinitives can be used as the object in the sentence. As a compliment, I didn't write the word completely here because I wanted to make it line like that. As a compliment, his desire is to, sorry, his desire is to become a doctor. What is his desire? To become a doctor. We normally say, if you ask children, what do you want to be in your future? I want to be a doctor, I want to be an engineer, I want to be a pilot. That's what it is. So we use as a compliment. Then also as an object to a preposition. The function is about to start. About is a preposition here, and object to that is what, to start. So this is an infinitive. Here to become is an infinitive, to work is an infinitive, to lie is an infinitive. So what you see here is that as a subject, as object, as a complement, and as a preposition. There are many other usages, but these are most important because we very often deal with these topics. So that's what I have mentioned here for you to learn. And there are some, I told you, infinitives are made with the 2 plus V1 form. There are certain verbs which do not take a 2 with it. So they are called infinitives without 2 or bare infinitives. Bare means without. Barefooted, we normally say. I mean, a person who do not wear chappals, foot, just walking on his foot is what is barefooted. So like that, without. So we call it bare infinitives. Like models. When you use models, models are can, could, may, might, shall, should, will, would, must, how to, all these are models. When we use that, we do not use to. Students must learn. We should not say must to learn. Students must learn. Must is a model. With the word let, make, bid and all that, when this comes in your sentence, let me try. We don't say let me to try. So there also we use an infinitive without to. Then words of perception like see, hear, smell, sorry. When these words are used also, we do not use infinitives without it. So these are called bare infinitives or infinitives without to. That's all basically I would like to explain to you today. Learn this and do the exercises from the sheet that I have given to you concerning this, the usages and infinitives without to. The remaining we'll see in the next class. Thank you.